the topic diencephalon. Now, what is diencephalon? Diencephalon is the part of forebrain. We have studied forebrain. It consists of three parts: olfactory lobe, cerebrum, and diencephalon. Out of these three, first two we have completed. Now let us study diencephalon. First, let us study the introduction of diencephalon, where exactly it is present in the brain, because it is a part of the brain. It is present below corpus callosum. Now, this diamond-shaped structure, whatever I have drawn, it is diencephalon. And this is human brain. And it is a diagrammatic representation of diencephalon. It is not actual figure. It is just the diagrammatic representation. And somewhere here, the diencephalon is present. So, it is present below corpus callosum. What is corpus callosum? Corpus callosum, it is the big commissure which connect the two cerebral hemisphere. Cerebral hemisphere, these are the part of cerebrum. So, the two cerebral hemispheres, they are connected by corpus callosum. And this diencephalon, it is just present below the corpus callosum and above the midbrain. Here, somewhere here, midbrain is coming. So, this diencephalon, it is present just above the midbrain and below corpus callosum. It is a diamond-shaped structure. So, roughly I have drawn diamond-shaped structure. Anterior connection. It encloses third ventricle. It is also called as diocele. Now, already we have studied what do you mean by ventricles. Ventricles are the big cavities. So, this diencephalon encloses a big cavity. This cavity is called as third ventricle, which is also called as diocele. Now, this third ventricle, anteriorly, this is anterior side, it is connected with the two lateral ventricles, because two lateral ventricles, they are present here in the cerebral hemisphere, and posteriorly here it connect with the fourth ventricle, because this fourth ventricle, it is present just below diencephalon. So here this is third ventricle, here two lateral ventricle, and here fourth ventricle is present. Now let us study exactly which parts are present in diencephalon. Diencephalon is made up of three parts. So, which are the three parts? Epithalamus, these two are thalami, and this third part is called as hypothalamus. What is the meaning of epi? Epi means above. The part which is present above the thalamus is called as epithalamus. You can say that the roof of the room, you can consider. It is called as epithalamus. The lateral side or the wall of the room are called as thalami, and the floor of the room is called as hypothalamus, because hypo means below, epi means above. So, diencephalon consists of three parts. You will remember epithalamus, thalami, and hypothalamus, and there are two thalami. Now we will study epithalamus. What is epithalamus? Epithalamus is the part of diencephalon. Diencephalon, it consists of three parts. We have studied epithalamus. These two are thalami, and this structure is called as hypothalamus. So one by one, we will study all the parts. Now we will start with epithalamus. Epi means above. The part which is present above, or you can say that the roof of the room. Just imagine a room. So the roof of the room is called as epithalamus. Here exactly epithalamus is present. It is non-nervous. What do you mean by non-nervous? Here the neurons, they are not present. This particular area only, the neurons are not present. Anteriorly, it fuses with the pyramidal, and it forms anterior choroid plexus, which secrete CSF. Now anteriorly means suppose this is epithalamus. One side is called as anterior, one side is called as posterior. So anterior side, it fuses with pia mater. What is pia mater? We have studied. Pia mater, it is the innermost layer of the meninges. There are three meninges, pia mater, dura mater and arachnoid mater. So innermost layer is called as pia mater. So this pia mater, it forms the anterior choroid plexus. Anterior choroid plexus means it is a collection of the nerves which is richly supplied with the blood capillaries so as to secrete one fluid called as CSF, cerebrospinal fluid. What is the function of cerebrospinal fluid? It protect and it provide the nutrition to the brain. That we have studied. The detailed function already we have studied. Now let us come to posterior side. The posterior side or the dorsal side, it is connected to pineal gland with pineal stalk. This red color structure which I have shown is the endocrine gland. The gland name is pineal gland and the stalk is called as pineal stalk. Now what is the function of endocrine gland? Endocrine glands are the ductless gland which secrete chemicals. These chemicals are known as hormones and these hormones are released in the bloodstream directly. Now, which hormone it is secreted by the pineal gland? Let us see. This pineal gland secrete one important hormone and the name of this hormone is melatonin. What is the function of melatonin? Function of melatonin. It is a sleep inducing hormone, or this melatonin, it is also called as hormone of darkness. Now what do you mean by hormone of darkness? Normally when the sun it falls and the darkness appear, slowly and slowly this pineal gland start becoming active, and during night at the time of approximately 9 o'clock, 9 p.m., this pineal gland becomes more active and start secreting melatonin, due to which we fall asleep. Or you can say that we become less and less active. This melatonin, it remains in our blood or in the body for approximately 12 hours. And as the day start, next day, the level of melatonin become less and less and we become active. This is the first function. Second function, it is also related with reproductive behavior. Now, it is related with reproductive behavior means what? It affects the puberty. It also affects the gonad function. Gonad means in case of male, it affects the testes. In case of female, it affects the ovaries and it also related with the pregnancy in human female.